It's September 5th today. Bit of a rainy day. Gray, overcast. Drizzling a bit right now. I've been doing some pruning and things around the yard. Today I want to do something interesting and kind of unexpected. I'm going to go ahead and repot and prune and root train my willow leaf ficus for the second time this year. You can see some really good radial root development, and you know, the roots seem to have just grown like crazy this year. There's a fine mat in there that actually, you know, the water isn't really penetrating through very quickly, and I can definitely see some roots growing, you know, maybe in a little bit weird directions. And yeah, so back in late April of this year, I repotted it for the first time after it had spent its whole life, over 2 years, in the same pot. It was almost destroyed by my neighbor at one point with a careless weed trimming incident. And then I didn't prune it at the time, and then I waited back in July of this year, about a month and a half ago, maybe a little bit less. I made this cut right here, and I made, you know, I cut off a couple smaller branches around it, but there's been a lot of new growth that has shot out from this cut point. There's two branches growing. Keeps going out of focus. There's a new bud right down here, and there's also a little bud right at the cut point there. You can see. Yeah, so four new ones coming out of there. So I'm gonna do some more major pruning. I think I'm gonna, oops, that was caught on that one over there. Yeah, so it's grown just way too strongly. I'm gonna cut it back, check its vigor, repot, and all that good stuff. I think it's, you know, it's healthy enough right now that there will be no problems doing this. And, you know, it'll have a little bit of time. There's still some decently good weather for another month or so. So it'll, you know, heal up from this, recover a bit and grow a little bit, and then I'll bring it inside for the winter where it can just kind of chill out. It didn't really grow too much indoors last year, just for the first few weeks or so, you know, letting out its energy, and then it just kind of went more or less dormant and then exploded in growth this year. So I'm hoping that's gonna happen again next year. All right, enough talking. I'm gonna go ahead and, actually, I'll probably do the chops first. Yeah. Okay, so I'll make the cuts first. You know, eventually this is going to be a mame sized tree. So, you know, max height is going to be something like this. You know, I'm hoping I can make this the root base, but it might be a little further down depending on how everything has grown in there this year. There was that big potato root that I cut in half last year, or when I repotted it. We'll see what's grown off of it since then. But yeah, so eventual mame sized, but for now it's just in training, so I don't need to worry about bringing it back to size. I think what I'm gonna do is leave three of these branches on. So I'm gonna leave this one alone. I'm gonna leave this one alone. This might be, yeah, I think probably the overall design, these will be gone because this will probably be the canopy here, but I'm gonna eventually prune this off. But for now, I wanna keep some vigor. So I'm just gonna keep Yeah, changed my mind. I'm just gonna keep two of these branches and not cut the tips of them so we can have some good sap flow through the length of the tree. Probably just should just make the big cut now, but I don't need to risk it. You know, this is a long-term project for me, so I'm just gonna make one cut here. That's that. So I can make three nice cuttings with that, and then a bunch of smaller ones. So I'll do that off camera afterwards. And yeah, that certainly changes things, but I really like it. And I'm starting to think about it now. I don't really need to grow this up as a huge sacrifice branch. I mean, this whole thing eventually is, you know, gonna be gone, so it's all sacrificial, but I can shorten it back a bit and hopefully have this one and this one kind of grow out at an even rate. I won't cut this one. I'll cut this one back to roughly the same size, a little bit shorter, just there. Yeah. I'm happy with that decision. And this will minimize the water needs for the tree. After it's repotted, it can just focus on getting settled into its new pot, its new soil. It'll be the same pot, but new soil. All right, I'm gonna get myself set up here for the repot. Okay, here goes. It's been a while since I did any repotting. My huge epic repotting season kind of burnt me out a little bit. It was like a month and a half of just straight repotting every day. So yeah, it's not completely root bound. Got the air conditioner starting off right now, that's perfect. It's not root bound, but I'm doing this more just as a training tool. You know, not because it's necessary. Get the roots growing at only the directions I want and get some fresh, nice soil in there for them to keep growing. Interesting in there. That's the cut point from last time. And just got a whole bunch of growth out of there. That's pretty cool. So, interesting. I'm thinking I might just chop everything back to the top root plane. Like, cut everything below that off. But first I'm gonna go wash this off and get a better idea of what it looks like. Hey, looking pretty cool in there. So yeah, tons and tons of root growth. So I'm wondering, because it keeps getting thicker until down there, I think actually I'm just gonna make the bottom my root base. It's like a perfect flat base and everything's growing out more or less radially. I'll prune a few things off, but I think that's really cool looking and a much better choice than up here. It just means, you know, the tree will have to be a little shorter because, you know, the distance from the soil to the top is how you measure the size of it. So mame, I forget the exact, but I think it, you know, it's got to be 10 centimeters or less. So 10 centimeters is about this, I think. I can measure it later, but yeah, we'll see. But yeah, that's gonna be my final decision. Cut off all these top roots, and then I can, you know, plant this a little bit, or, you know, less deep, not as deep in the pot. This is not the choice that I thought I was gonna be making today, but I gotta adapt as I go. Make choices on the fly. Cut that little root out of there. Got this one crossing a little bit. Cut it back to that small bit. That one's a weird angle. There's a small one coming out of here. Maybe I can train it. If not, just cut it at that angle, so hopefully roots will grow out this way. And for now, that small one can take over. It's not coming out radially. It can probably be trained. So I think I'll leave that for now. There's a couple growing on top of each other here. I'll get rid of the thicker one on the bottom. I think I'll get rid of this big one up here because it's higher up than all the other ones and it's a little thick and growing in a weird direction. These ones can replace it, they're better. Yeah, so the rest of these, you know, some of them aren't perfect, but I think I want to leave everything for now. Just see how it all develops. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Dang. So much development just in the last year. You know, after this thing had been almost destroyed by my neighbor. I think, like I said earlier, there was a careless yard trimmer incident. Anyways, that was our old place. We moved out of there. Getting everything back to a nice manageable length for the pot. Making sure I got good growing angles for everything. Yeah. Is that on camera? I think that's good for now. I really like that. Really, really like that, actually. And this... we can, maybe I'll find my stone blade and just make these cuts a little bit more flush. Or, no, I'll just do it like this. Same effect. Didn't want to spend time looking for my stone blade. Just get this finished. Looking pretty good. That one's fine. Yeah, okay. No more playing around with that. We'll get the pot set up and get this potted. Cool little tree. Okay, so I've got a little mound of soil in there for this to rest on. And I'm planting it a little bit higher in the pot to allow the roots to grow down and strong before I put this tree, probably next time, hopefully this time next year, I can put this into a shallow training bonsai pot. Making sure all the roots are growing out radially as best as they can. And I think that's a good planting angle. For the future vision of the tree. Might be a little bit different, but for now, this is how it'll develop. Yeah, looks good. You don't really need to do a lot of this working the soil into the roots. There was just that one plane of roots, but it's always better to be safe than sorry. And then I'll put some extra soil on top for now. I don't need to expose the roots or the nabari just yet. As long as I know it's developing nicely down there, that works for me. Alright, just get this watered in off camera and be right back for the outro. Alright, so before I pop these new cuttings into the soil, I just wanted to show the progress on the old cuttings. So I've got one still alive, growing lots of new shoots. Two, still alive, growing a couple little new shoots. And there is a third one right here that's still alive, but it's not growing anything. But I'm really happy with this one and this one. That's very cool. Bunch of crown of thorns cutting still alive as well. So I'll plant these in the soil and then I'll finish up this video. But I'm really liking how this tree looks right now. Very happy with it. Okay, there's the rest of the new cuttings planted up. I'll keep everything nice and misted. Not too wet in there, just humid. Keep my fingers crossed, and with any luck, this time next year, I'll have a whole bunch of willow leaf ficus trees that I can play around with. I really like this species so far. My experience with it has been all positive. Yeah, really cool. Fun species to grow. I really like how the bark is looking. You know, just continually, you know, constantly splitting with the green coming in underneath and the kind of lines, the furrows of dark, you know, brown bark, the older stuff. So yeah, it'll look cool as it grows. And hopefully I'll get some more character shape into it. And in the far future, it can be my prize mame bonsai. I'm not gonna grow a lot of mame sized trees. I think just this one and a cedar I have right now are the two that I'm planning to keep that small. But yeah, anyways, see how it grows. That's it for this one. As always, thanks for watching. Catch you next time. Cheers.